Hello. So today's topic is FSM. FSM means finite state machine, or it can be said interchangeably finite automata. Both are used depending on the various books. So FSM can be of two types generally. One without output, or without. Now, without output is also two type of variety, like Moore machine and Mealy machine. And with output, DFA is one type of FSM, or NFA can be, or epsilon NFA. Now, this DFA, that means deterministic finite automata, and the NFA stands for non-deterministic finite automata. We will shortly see what do we mean by deterministic or non-deterministic, and finally epsilon non-deterministic finite automata. Okay, today's topic actually is DFA. We will know about DFA, how why it is called this kind of deterministic term, and various examples on this DFA. So first of all, this DFA, that means deterministic finite automata, is the simplest model, of our computation, and it has very little or very limited memory. Now, now we have to habituated with some diagram. It's called transition diagram or state transition diagram. What do you mean by states? See this picture. Suppose the actually in this diagram, state transition diagram, these circle denotes some states. There A is an is a state. B is a state, C is a state, and there are some arrows. Here is arrows. These arrows actually denotes the transition. Okay, and this transition depends on some input symbol. Here you are seeing some zero is there. So if we are in now in state A and we are getting some zero, then we are going to state B. If we are in now state A and we have a get input, an input like 1, then we are going to state C. So in this state transition diagram, if we are sitting on some state and we are getting some out input, then we are going somewhere. Fine. Now here is another type of arrow is there. This one is coming from nowhere. That means this arrow is coming from A and going to B. This arrow coming from A and going to C. But this arrow has no source. This kind of arrow denotes that this state is our initial state. That is, if a machine is on now, then first the initial state will be this. Now let see its formal definition. Okay, formal definition means each and every automata have some formal definition. We will define it formally. Now, if we define some formally, then the definition comes like this. This FSM or finite automata contains 5 tuples. It contains 5 tuples. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now, first one is Q. Now, what means this Q? This capital Q denotes set of states. That means every DFA contains obviously some states, a set of states will be there. Now this summation. You already aware with the summation, that is a set of symbols, and in case of definition, this denotes the inputs, that means set of inputs, which inputs are going to be used in our machine. And Q0, that is our initial state. Okay, this will be our initial state. So if we compare with this this diagram with the formal definition, then our summation or sigma or inputs will be 0 or 1, because only these two kind of inputs we are using. Next one is Q0. So it denotes the initial states. For this picture, these initial states will be A, and F, it denotes the set of final state. I didn't tell yet about this initial states. Let's say about this initial state. Now, first of all, these diagrams still not a DFA actually, because DFA, that means deterministic term, denotes each and every, for each and every state, for each and every input, all destination will be written there. So if we look at this A, we have only two kind of input, that is 0 and 1. And for A, we will see for 0 it is going B, and for 1 it is going C. So A is all right, it's all kind of destination is described here. But if we see at B, then if we are getting at this B 0 or 1, we couldn't say where it will go, then it is non-deterministic. But if there is some kind of transition is there, that it is showing that yes, it is every possibilities are there described in our transition diagram, then it is known as DFA. So we are going to convert this diagram to a DFA. Suppose there is another state D. Okay, and if suppose this B is there, and we are getting a 0, then we going back to this A. But if we are getting some 1, then we are here. Fine. And like this, suppose in this C, we are getting some 1, then we are going back to 1, A, and if I get in some 0, then we are going to D. Now D is remaining here. Suppose there are also some arrows like this. Fine. So now in this picture, each and every states clearly determines their destination for all possible inputs. And suppose this D is our destination. If final destination, rather say, that means our machine is answering some yes or no, yes, this is acceptable or this is not acceptable, this kind of answers, then this machine must be halt at the final state. And suppose the in this diagram, in this state transition diagram, this D is our final state. And in automata or our this course, we denote this D or the final state in double circle like this. So and we are saying that set of final state, that means it may be more than one. And finally, the transition function, this delta denotes the transition function. That is, Q is some state, and if we apply some input in at this state, then we are going to some new state. These are known as transition function. So if we write for this diagram this kind of thing, then we can say for this diagram Q is A, B, C, D, and this sigma will be 0 and 1, and Q0 is A, and if that is here D, but since we are saying that if our final state is a set, so we are writing like this, denoting it as a set. And finally, this delta, it is, suppose A into 0 is going to B, A into 1 is going to C, B into 0 is going to A. So all kind of this transition will be written or will remain into the transition function, right? And from this transition function or this diagram, we also can draw a transition table. So many times we will be provide this kind of some tables, and we have to draw the parallel transition diagram, or the reverse can be true. Now this side will denote our possible states A, B, C, D, and here also the final states is lined in a circle. And these rows denotes the inputs, that is 1, 0, and 1 for this machine. Now in if we are in A and we are getting 0, then we are going B. And we are getting 1, then we are going to C. And if like this in B, by getting 0, we are going to A again. At B we are getting 1, then we are going to D. And so like this is known as transition table, and this thing is known as transition diagram or state transition diagrams. Now let's say some important examples. First example 1. You already know about some L in the previous class. L means language. So let's draw automata or DFA, that is deterministic finite automata, for some language L1 means, suppose, set of all strings that starts with zero. We are going to design some machine which will accept set of all strings that start with 0. So L1 means you can assume 0, because starts with 0, this will be accepted. Suppose 00, this also will be accepted. 01 will be accepted, but if 10 will not be accepted. Fine. Again 000, 001, these all are going to be accepted by this language. And since it has no other constraints or about any length, so obviously this kind of language or this language is infinite. This is a kind of infinite language. But no problem, it is infinite or not infinite, we can draw its corresponding DFA. Now see how we are drawing this kind of, or how can we solve this kind of problems. Each and every time there will be initial states there. Suppose initial states is our A. Well, and this arrow denotes this is our initial state. Now, if we are getting some zero, then we are going some new state B. Now, say we are getting then 0 or 1 or anything. These all kind of strings, these all kind of strings are going to be accepted by this machine. So when we are in B and we are getting 0 or 1 or 0, anything, we are going to be accepted. And since if we are in B, that means we are already accepted like this, because simple 0 is also in our language, belongs to our language. So obviously this B is our final state. Fine. This B can be said as our final state. And suppose but another case is there, that initially we can't get any 0. We are getting some 1. Fine. Then this machine cannot accept this one. Suppose there is some another state like C, and if we are getting 1 at A, then we are going to this state C. And since we are getting anything, we can get anything 0 or 1, no problem or nothing for effect for this machine is not to be accepted anymore. So we can recite this 0 and 1, this loop, self loop in C. Fine. Now each and every machine or any machine can have some like this kind of state. Fine. Not all machine, but some machine can have some kind of state that is not to be accepted, and we are surely know any further progress can be possible for this state, from this state. These kind of states are known as dead state. Fine. Dead state or trapped state. Trap. That means we are trapped here, or further going is not possible. So these kind of states are known as dead state or trap state. And since it is our final state, so we are double circling this P. I think for such example you are getting some clear concept. In more two to three examples we will see. Let's take some another examples. Examples 2. Let's make some machine like the language L1 can accept set of all strings over 0 or 1 of length 2. Here. So if this kind of questions are there, then what to do? Let's assume let's think that what are the inputs or what are the strings will reside in this language. This set of all strings over 0, 1 but length 2. So 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0 and 1, 1. These 4 are all possible input for this language. Clear? Now, for this machine, this is our L or language and summation is this. Now, how to draw? Again, we are initiate some state A and if we are getting some input, it may 0 or may 1. No problem. So in both case we are going to B. Next in B we can again get anything 0 or 1. No problem is that because there is no constraints about 0 or 1 in this language. Only the constraints is length 2. And 1 and we are going this state C. Now suppose 0, 0 is our string. Then in A we are getting 0, we are going to B. And in B we are going getting again 0 and we are going to C. And this 0, 0 belongs to this language. So this is going to be accepted by this machine. So this C is our final state. Clear? And suppose in this C suppose some strings arrived like 000, but this string cannot be accepted by our machine because the length is 2. So what we will do, this if after reaching this C we are again getting some inputs 0 or 1 anything, then some state called D, we are going some state called D, and these these strings will not be accepted. That's why again this D is the dead state for this language. So this is our machine for this language. Now let's take another example, another important example, example 3. It says this machine is going to accept any string over A, B, that does not contain the string any string over a b that does not contain the string a b b in it. Okay, now first think about this question. What is the problem? Suppose here is some string is appeared like triple a b b a, but this string contains this part, that is a a b b. So this string will not should be accepted by our machine. But if a b a b, this kind of string appeared, then it should be accepted. So actually this kind of thing is slightly difficult to draw directly. In this case, in this kind of cases, we will first draw a simpler one means, first of all, these try to design this problem in a simpler format. Try design simpler problem. This means if some questions say that these machines are going to be accepted this kind of thing, then it is most simpler. But if such machine are going to say that no, this machine doesn't contain this type of thing, then it is much more difficult. So in this kind of thing we will do first the reverse one. That means we will first draw some picture, some diagram which will contain this, or which will accept, this kind of string. Okay, so let us construct a DFA that accepts all strings over A and B that contains string A A B in. Fine. So let's draw it. Again, we have some initial state, and if we are getting some A, then we are going to a new state B. Fine. If before that we are getting some B B B, like this B B B B A B B, so this mean nothing for this diagram. We have to perform some operation at this point. So if we are getting only B, then we have not to worry, we just reside in our same position. That means we are not changing our state. If we are getting just a, then yes, we have to do something, and we are changing our state to a new state called b. Next we have to see, or we are looking for some a, and we are going to a new state C. Again, we can we have to see for some B. Suppose in C we are getting some B and we are going to a new state, that is D, by putting B. And after that, this E. Obviously, I think you are have some hint or from the previous examples that since AABB, so E again will be our final state. Fine. But still not, it is a DFA because many more options are there. Suppose for A, B and A both are decided, but in B we can get a A. A is determined, but B. Now, if many B's are there, then we are getting some A. After that, a B, then this AABB will not be possible here. So, again, we have to move in the previous stage. So, if in B we are getting some B, then we are going back to A and we will start a new journey for the searching purpose of AABB. Again, if we in C, that means we are decides in C and we are getting some A. Suppose A, B. Okay. Now, by getting this 2A, we are now at C. And again, we are getting some A. So, no problem if, because if, suppose, AABB, still this stage, this state can be accepted. So, no, in C, if we are getting some A's, no worries about that. We are residing in the same state, A. And in case of D, if we are getting some A is there, then we have to get another A. Suppose A, B, and again A, one A is there. Then we need to search for again one A, then B. So from D, we can go back to B for a A. Clear? So this is a, and finally any string that contain this AABB. So if we are getting some this portion AABB and suppose this kind of string, any B's can be there, any S can be there, no worry about that. These kind of strings all are going to be accepted by this machine. So here will be a self loop for A and B. Clear? Now let's check about our actual problem. That means this is our reverse one. So, to get the actual one, we need to do just flipping the state. Okay, by flipping the states, we can draw the reverse picture. So, flip the states. How can you flip the states? Make the final states into non-final states and the non-final state to the final states. So, make the final states to non-final and vice versa. That is the non-finals to final states. So, this picture will be like this. A, since it is non-final, in this case it will be a final, and as well as initial also, no problem for that. B is not final, so here B also will be a final. C is non-final, so it also will be a final. D is same. Here only the final state was E, so here E will be a normal state. And the transition diagram will be as before, that is A, B, A, A, B, A, B, and A, B. This is our actual machine we want to draw for this example 3. Fine? Okay, thank you.